Hello everyone, welcome back to Geek Disorder's web series over HTML5, CSS3, JavaScript, and jQuery. This is Lavik, I'll be walking you through this series. Okay, today we're going to be going over how to code comments and whitespace in your web pages. So, what is a comment? Well, a comment is something that appears between... I'll just do it right here. It appears between this. That's the opening of a comment, and I can type this is a comment, and then this is the closing of a comment. Okay, the browser ignores comments. A comment can be used to explain or describe code that might be confusing to someone if they were taking a look at your web page. It can be used to comment out elements in your web page for testing. Say, I wanted to see what my web page would look like if I removed this header one here. So I could just comment it out like this, and that would not show up in my web page. And I can actually show you that working. If you notice right here, above my header one, I have this comment, and if I go ahead and launch this in Firefox. Oops. Of course, you do have to save this first, so I'm going to save it. I'm just going to save it on my desktop. I'm not even going to change the name, but I am going to add .html to the end of it, so it is a web page. Okay, there we go. All right, now if I just go to run and I launch this in Firefox, there we go. I have my header and my paragraph here, and you see that comment right here, this is a comment, is not shown. If I wanted to see what my web page would look like without this header, all I'd have to do is comment it out as such. As if you notice, when I open my comment, everything turned green. That means that if I don't close it, well, and I keep forgetting to save, let's try that again. Nothing's going to show up, even though I didn't close my my header here and my comment. It comments out everything after that. So to fix that, I just close my comment, and I did not save again. I'm doing real well today. All right, here we go, and you see my header is gone. So comments can be used for testing purposes to see what things look like if you take them out and such. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove this comment, and I'm gonna remove this one. There we go. Okay, a comment can span multiple lines, or it can be on a single line. So if I want to say I want to make a comment here and say, this is the body of my web page. Okay, I can make a comment just one line, or I can do this. This is a comment on more than one line. And there we go. So, a comment includes everything up until the ending of the comment, even if that covers multiple lines. Alright, the next thing we're going to cover is whitespace in your web page. What is whitespace? Well, whitespace consists of characters, like your line return character. Every time you hit the enter key, that's a line return character. Extra spaces, so every time you hit a space bar, that's whitespace. The tab characters, if you tab inside your web page, that's all white space. Okay, so all of this indenting right here, that these tabs I did, that's white space. When I hit the return key, this is white space. So I've got white space right here, and such. And then of course, if I was to do this. For some reason, you can have multiple elements on one line. If I was to make another header here, and and then close it. These spaces here, that's white space. Okay. White space is ignored by the browser also. It can be used to indent lines. It can be used to separate elements from one another if you're putting them on the same line. It's good coding practice to indent. It makes your web page a lot easier to read. But you do not want to overuse white space. So, because it does add to your file size, which little bitty web pages, that really doesn't matter. But if you look at like Google's and Yahoo's and, you know, any big search engine, most of the time, most of those companies have a program that removes all the white space from their code after they get done coding a web page or dynamically creating it. The reason being is, even though the white space takes up not that much room, when you have millions and billions of web pages, that really adds up. So, okay, well, this has been covering comments and white space. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you like our content here at Geek Disorder, please subscribe. And I'm Lavik, and I'll see you next time.